Signing out, ES News, Andy Emilio, and why.
Welcome to Madison Square Garden and the official kickoff press conference for the May 20th World Championship. HBO broadcast from the big room featuring Terrence Crawford defending his WBC and WBO super lightweight titles against Felix Diaz. Just a couple of short announcements before I turn the program over. Tickets go on sale tomorrow at 10 a.m. priced at $250, $150, $100, $75, $50, and $35. I believe we have a 10:15 Eastern HBO start. The opening fight that night will feature a lightweight battle, 12 rounds. One of the participants is here between Ray Beltran and Jonathan Maciello. Jonathan is here. He lives in New Jersey, but he's a native of Peru. I'd like to introduce him and just have him come up and say a few words with his translator, Butch Perez. Jonathan, come on up, Butch.
Muchas gracias por la oportunidad que me están dando. Gracias a Dios que siempre me está abriendo las puertas. Gracias a Top Gun por el apoyo. Gracias a HBO por darme esta oportunidad. Y nada, estoy contento de estar aquí, motivado 100% y a ganar el 20 de mayo. Y quiero felicitar a los dos campeones que están aquí, a Terrence Crawford, acá el dominicano, mi hermano, que sea una gran pelea. A los dos los admiro como peleadores. Muchas gracias.
He would like to say that he wants to thank Top Rank, HBO. He also is happy to be on a card like Terrence Crawford and Diaz. And he's looking for a good fight against Ray Beltran, and it's going to be an action-packed fight, and thank you, everybody.
This is a fight in the lightweight division, a division that, for some reason, suddenly is starting to heat up. With good champions and a lot of good contenders, so the winner of this is really going to put himself in a formidable position to move forward. I'd like to turn the program now over to the president of Top Rank, Todd DeBuff. Just so you know, Bob Arum is currently in Washington, D.C. We have a show this weekend on HBO featuring Vasily Lomachenko and Jason Sosa. Bob literally is doing a lunch interview with the editors of the Washington Post.
And he's meeting with General Flynn.
No, I for some reason I have to believe the topic of conversation is more who resides at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue as opposed to Lomachenko. But let me introduce the president of Top Rank, Mr. Todd DeBuff. Thank you.
Thanks, Carl. So when we sent out the release for this fight, it's everybody called us up like, well, what the hell's going on? And the reality of it was that we'd like to thank the New York Knicks. We all know that this time of the year is a real playoff driven year. And it's so hard to get into the building. And we were at a fight down in the theater with Michael Conlon, and we were doing press conference, and Joel and everybody's like, so where are you going May 20? We're like, well, we're looking at another building. We think we can make it happen. And when you hear that, you kind of get goosebumps, because not often do you get to play the big building. And an honor for both of all the fighters up here is, not often do you get a fight in the big building. So it's really an honor for us to promote, and it's an honor for all of these guys to fight in the Madison Square Garden. And it couldn't have happened without Joel Fisher and his great staff. So I'd like to introduce Joel Fisher.
Thanks, Todd. And yeah, we got lucky, but we are thrilled that the fight is here. I want to welcome everybody to Chase Square here, and welcome you back to the Mecca of boxing, Madison Square Garden. 2 weeks ago, we had over 25,000 fans here at the Garden. First, the fight in the theater with the professional debut of Michael Conlon sold out. And then, of course, the Gennady Golovkin, Daniel Jacobs fight in the arena, which was just a great fight. New York fans clearly have an appetite for great boxing, and we're thrilled to put great boxing on here at the Garden. We're thrilled that we have the World Junior Welterweight Championship here on May 20th. We want to welcome back Terrence Crawford and all of Omaha Nation back to the Garden. We also want to welcome Felix Diaz, the 2008 gold medalist, and all the other fighters that are going to fight on this card. Should be a great night. World Championship fights at Madison Square Garden, the mecca of boxing. There's absolutely nothing better. It's a thrill to be working with Bob, Todd, Carl again. It's great to be working with Lou. Can't imagine where you've been, Lou. So it's great to have you back here. And obviously Peter Nelson and HBO if you can't make it here. Should be a great night on May 20th. We're thrilled to be hosting this event. We look forward to seeing you all on May 20th. Thanks.
The fight will be televised on HBO. HBO has obviously been the gold standard for many years. They have brought so many incredible boxing events to all of our airwaves. They have developed fighters, they have showcased fighters, and they have obviously introduced incredible documentary style programming like 24/7, Real Sports, etc. At the helm of HBO Sports is Peter Nelson, who has taken the leadership of a company with great pride and continued its excellence. I'd like to introduce Peter Nelson.
Thank you, Todd. I want to thank the press for being here. I also want to thank the press for pushing for this fight. As everyone knows, Terrence Crawford fights anyone, any place, anytime. He's never backed down from a challenge. Anytime anyone's brought up any name and any style, puncher, boxer, orthodox, southpaw, anything, go to Terrence and ask him to take the fight, he takes the fight. And that's what great champions do. That's the job. So I want to thank Team Crawford for always stepping up, for exemplifying the type of excellence that the fans expect of their champions. I want to thank Joel Fisher and the team at the Garden. It's always great to be here. Privilege, for sure. We were here a couple weeks ago and we're excited to come back. I want to thank Top Rank, Todd DeBuff, Bob Arum, Carl Moretti. As Todd and Carl mentioned, Bob's down right now preparing for our event this Saturday with Vasyl Lomachenko, as well as a great co-feature in Gvozdik and an opener in cruiserweight Usyk. So we look forward to a great month of boxing ahead, from the fight this weekend to the Canelo Chavez pay-per-view, and then onward to this fight here at the Big Room in the Garden. We're thrilled for it. Terrence is also pulling off a rare double competition in the same month, and that his special, My Fight, from last year was nominated for a Sports Emmy. So on May 9th, he'll be competing then, and then on May 20th, he'll be competing again. I want to thank Team Diaz for stepping up and taking a fight against a fighter. A lot of fighters don't want to fight. Typifies the type of bravery that we expect from champions who really want to make it. I see Mr. Marley there associated with the team. Thank you for helping get the deal done, as well as Lou DiBella, my old friend. I'm glad the coffee's on the ground there. I want to get you post-caffeination, so it's a good way to get Lou. Cameron Duncan, BOMAC, everyone up here. It's a privilege to work with such a great group of people. Our start time is 10:15 on May 20th. I look forward to seeing you all there. Thank you.
When putting on an event, or deciding who's going to be participating in the event, obviously we have to talk to the teams. We had a wonderful conversation with Terrence, Cameron, Brian, and they just said, just bring it on, we just want to fight. We just want to keep fighting. And that's the throwback old style we love. Insert X. HBO executive, come promoter, come podcast extraordinaire. Lou DiBella into the situation. And he, some people go to work, they hit the clock, they go in, they get the time hours, everything. Lou picks up the phone and starts screaming at every press guy why this guy should get his fight, his guy should get a fight. And you know, and as Peter said, I'd like to thank the press for making this fight. Whatever happens, however this stuff gets done, I don't know anymore, but Lou DiBella was a big part of it, and I'd like to have Lou DiBella introduce Felix Diaz.
And what the fuck, it worked. First of all, I want to thank HBO, Peter Nelson. You just had a terrific pay-per-view event here in the Garden. Joel, thank you. I mean, I was walking around, it's been a long time since I walked around the inside of Madison Square Garden, and it felt pretty good that night. To have a fight of that magnitude in MSG was, it felt good to be a part of that environment that night, and that was a great night for boxing in Madison Square Garden. Thank you, Top Rank. You cut a hard deal, but you cut a deal. So I'm appreciative of that. We were chasing around Bud Crawford for a long time because he'll fight anybody, because he's the best, because he's never run away from a challenge. Like, there was no disrespect in us chasing him for that long period of time. It's because Felix Diaz knew that to assert his own abilities and to prove who he is as a fighter, he needed to get into a ring with someone who had already been given the opportunity to do that. And that's why we chased Crawford so hard, because we knew he was the kind of champion that doesn't duck a challenge, that isn't afraid of anybody, and that might just give Diaz this opportunity. And then honestly, this was sort of a by any means necessary sort of chase. Like, we just wanted to get Felix this fight, and that's what he did. I want to thank Felix's co-manager, Jose Nunez, their lawyer, Mike Marley, for their assistance in that. His trainer, Joel Diaz, who couldn't be with us today. And mostly, I want to thank Felix Diaz. There's a reason he won an Olympic gold medal, because he's one of the best fighters at his weight in the world. There's a reason why he went to hostile territory and most people thought he'd beat Lamont Peterson, because he's that good. And there's a reason why he went up in weight outside of his own weight class and did real damage to Sammy Vasquez and won that fight, because great fighters do what they have to do to win, even if it's at 7 pounds heavier than they're used to fighting. This is a really, really good fight for fight fans. It's a really, really good fight for HBO, for the Garden. Felix has the big New York Dominican community, Washington Heights and elsewhere. I think they're going to come out and support him. I know Bud's going to travel more people from Omaha than you could possibly believe, and that he has a fan base everywhere as a pound-for-pound fighter. I expect a great fight on May 20th. I thank everybody involved. I want to bring up, to say a few words, the former Olympic gold medalist, one of the best fighters in the world at 140 pounds, and his strength and conditioning coach, Al Teresa, will be kind enough to do the translation for us. So Felix Diaz and Al Teresa.
Buenas tardes a todos. Primeramente quiero darle las gracias a Dios, al Team Crawford, que me ha dado la oportunidad, mi equipo de trabajo que lo consiguió, José Núñez, Ay Hermon, Ludy Vela, y nada, esperando que lo que viene para el 20 de mayo sea algo grande, lo que es poderme coronar campeón mundial.
First, I want to thank God I want to thank Team Crawford for giving us the opportunity to take on such a big fight. I want to thank Lou DiBella, Al Heyman, HBO. On the 20th, it's going to be an incredible opportunity for him.
Como diría, vengo de pelear con los grandes. Cuando firmé con mi manager José Núñez, le dije que quería pelear con los mejores. Estoy peleando con los mejores. Desde el Crawford es uno de los mejores boxeadores en estos momentos y me siento muy bien por con quién voy a pelear en este momento.
When I was arguing with my managers about fighting the biggest fights out there, Crawford was number one since he's the best out there. And it's such an amazing opportunity to finally get that fight with him.
Y nada, esperando el apoyo de todo mi pueblo dominicano, el 20 de mayo, me hizo buen colgarle a dar lo mejor de mí. Gracias.
And especially want to thank all the support that I'm going to get from all the people from the Dominican Republic that's going to be here on the 20th of May. And we'll wait to see everybody there. Thank you.
You know, one of the great things is when you're at a press conference and it's your turn to introduce your fighter or the guy that you're associated with, it's easy to, you start to reflect, how did you get here? And honestly, I can tell you the truth is, one of the harder things to do is to not start with somebody from the beginning, but to inherit them a little bit into their careers. We've had a really good success of taking guys from the pro debut all the way through. And in Terrence's situation, that wasn't the case. We took him on a little later when he had a couple fights under his belt. And this meteoric rise came down to one thing. He's a fighter. And little opportunities came up. Never forget, we were in Las Vegas and there was an opportunity for him to fight Prescott, who had knocked out Amir Khan. And everyone says, this guy's a beast. He's a tough right-handed puncher. And Cameron Duncan was quiet. Brian McIntyre was like, hell, let's do it. So was Terrence. Boom, there we go. Next big opportunity, a fighter turns down a fight with Gamboa. The door opens, Terrence walks through it, and here we go. Omaha, Nebraska, 10,000 people, and he took that opportunity. So this example is an example that we wish I could get in prize fighting. It is called prize fighting because when you take the risk, you get the prize. The prize is you're filling the garden. You're coming back here in the big building. You're considered fighter of the year 2 years ago. You're pound for pound in the top two across the board. That's the prize. And that prize could not have been done or accomplished with Terrence in the ring, or with his advisor Cameron Duncan, or with his wingman Brian McIntyre. I'd like to introduce Brian McIntyre.
First, I just want to thank God for giving Team Crawford and Terrence Crawford another chance to shine. And this time, God put us on the biggest stage of all, the Madison Square Garden. I want to thank Peter Nelson, real good friend, especially Top Rain, always coming through, and Cameron Duncan. And Team Crawford is a team. And I can't do this alone, so I want to just bring up Saul Diegues and Red Spikes. Let's go. I know y'all don't like coming up here, but hey, these guys put a lot of work in with them. You want to say something, Saul? I brought them up here to say something. They don't want to say nothing. but these guys, my left hand, They're right there in the trenches, right there with Terrence, giving advice, help cook, help drive. I mean, it's a team effort. And we can't do this alone. So, then there's more. There's strength and conditioning trainers, there's nutritionists, there's doctors. So it's a team effort. But now I want to switch my attention over to this crew over here. Yeah, man, I respect you 100%. You got a good team around you. You got Ariza, and we all know his story. You got DeBella. That's a different story. But I know those guys are world class, all of them. DeBella, Ariza, and his trainer, Diaz, whatever his training name is. They world class. He produced Tim Bradley, so I know those guys are really good. And I will say this, we do got our work cut out for us. But I will say this, they've been asking for this fight and asking for this fight, lying, doing this, saying this, saying that. Y'all finally gonna get what y'all looking for. And I appreciate that. Have a good day.
Somebody's phone here, Brian? You left them something. We all talk about, like I talked earlier about somebody opening up, the door opens and they take a step through. Terrence, he not only takes a step through, but he just, every time he just delivers. And one of the sneaky things about him is that he just loves to finish guys when they get hurt. And that makes him very telegenic, right? And we're really in the industry of, fans connecting to somebody who does it. So if it's in Omaha, Nebraska, or if it's in Las Vegas, or if it's in New York, Terrence lights it up. I'd like to introduce two-time world champion and pound for pound, one of the top two guys in the world. Well, I'll say pound for pound the best. There we go, Terrence Crawford.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank God for blessing me with the skills and the ability to be here in front of you guys. I'd like to thank Todd Rain, HBO, for all y'all done for me, my coaches, managers, everybody that's part of Team Crawford. I'd like to thank Madison Square Garden for bringing me back to Broadway. It's gonna be a fun night. It's gonna be a real fun night. I'm real excited for this fight. I'm real up for it. I've been reading all the blogs, people been sending me for the last couple of days telling me that this guy said I'm scared of him and I've been ducking him. And everybody knows Terrence Crawford ducks no one. So I'm up for it. I'm real excited. I'm happy that he got the chance to get the fight. Lou DeBella. I'm not running, boy. Not running.
Never said you were.
So we're here now, and that's all I gotta say. Let's May 20th. May the better man win.
See, he's learned something. Last time Hank Lunday was in his grill, we had like a scrap up here, right? Anyway, thanks everyone for showing up. I think tickets are on sale tomorrow, is that it? 250, 150, 150. We look forward to it. This is going to be a great night. Thank you to everyone. And the guys will be around for some one-on-ones. Thank you.
Okay.
Right here, please. Right here. Thank you. Right here. Thank you. Thank you.
You guys go too. You can't get a good picture. Thank you.
Down in the middle.
I didn't say no.
I didn't say no.